Shalom. Before we get Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Before we get started, I want to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah Ba'ashem, Harakak Wadash, double honors to my elder apostles, great millstone, ruling teach well, and honors and salutations to the Akima, great millstone, pushing this truth throughout the four corners in these last days. Shalom. Okay? And I'm going to make this quick as possible. All right? And this is just a quick sit down, linebacking off this video that the brother posted, GMS Vegas sit down, 144,000. Well, it say 144K, which K represent 1,000. All right, and the title says signs and wonders and droughts. It is at an all time high, but at the end it shall speak. All right, and that's right. We're watching the Lord work. The Lord is. Let me get that precept. It's time for thee to work, O Lord. All right, we're going to come back to those. Time for thee. Should be in Psalms. Yeah, Psalms 119 and 126. It is time for thee, Lord Yahweh, to work, for they have made void thy law. That's right. All right, so that's what the Lord is doing. The Lord is bringing evil on the earth. All right, and all this is prophecy. That's why you had prophets saying all this was gonna happen before it happened, showing you that the Lord is dealing with those men, beginning with the elder apostles, great millstone, down to the least of us. Okay, so let's go back. We're not gonna watch the video because I don't want to start it all over and shit, but I'm recommending it because it's a great video. All right, signs and wonders and droughts. All right, you know what's going on in California. Wait, hold on. But yeah, you know what's going on, these wildfires that's going on in California, you know. And in this same video, it got a lady, she was like, this is not normal, you know. Because, you know, these wildfires is hitting record numbers, you know. All these so-called natural disasters is hitting record numbers, all right. And it's going to increase. Okay, in these last days, before the day of the Lord, before the Lord make his great return, okay? All right. So let's get this other precept. All right. This Psalms 148:7-8, and it says, praise the Lord Yahweh from the earth, ye dragons and all deeps. Fire and hail, snow and vapor, stormy wind fulfilling his word. Okay, so when all these different things happen on earth, you know, when a flood happens, when all these different things happen, it's ultimately being controlled by the Lord. And yes, contrary to popular belief, the Lord uses men to also manifest these prophecies. For instance, World War III, you know, the Lord is causing these men, all right, these of these different nations, these rulers of these different nations, presidents, he's going to cause them to go to war with each other. Okay, the Lord must have hosted a battle. And also when Esau you know, when Esau causes a flood to happen, or, you know, or the things, this order out of chaos that Esau is doing, is ultimately the Lord making him do it. Okay? Because like a video I did a while back, you know, the Lord, he's omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent. Okay? And the Lord, he's going to make it known in these days how powerful he really is. All right, so let's get the next one. This is Isaiah 29:6. It says, thou shalt be visited of the Lord of hosts with thunder and with earthquake and great noise, with storm and tempest and the flame of devouring fire. All right. You know, but of course, Esau, he's going to play on the minds of you simpletons and just downplay it like it's just some natural disaster. Hey, Ezra, keep it low. You know, so, you know, that's what Esau does. He try to keep, he's not going to tell you the truth at all. All right. He's going to downplay it. All right. When he speak of a lie, he speak of his own. Okay. The scriptures call him the father of lies. All right. The devil. All right. And that word, devil, Salakia, devil, Diablos, okay, it goes into a slander, accuser, okay, so he's not upright, which that word devil and Satan is interchangeable, all right, and they all is all talking about Esau, the so-called white man, all right. Okay, so let's get this next one. This Zephaniah 3:5. It says, the just Lord Yahweh is in the midst thereof. He will not do iniquity. Every morning doth he bring his judgment to light. All right. So every morning the Lord is you know, bringing out judgment on the earth. All right. So every morning doth he bring his judgment to light. He faileth not, but the unjust knoweth no shame. Okay. Now let's go to Romans. I mean, not Romans. 2 Ezra. This 2 Ezra 9:1. It says, He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. Okay. So you're supposed to be watching the times you living in. All right. And it says, And that's what you call being prudent. All right, and we're going to get that next. Measure thou the time diligently in itself, and when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand. Because you got heathens, like, you got Edomites. They know perfectly what times they're living in. Okay? And what you call them doomsday preppers. All right, but it's all in vain, you know, it's all in vain. They're not going to escape the judgment that the Lord has set for this place and for them. Okay. But at least they got common sense to see what's happening around the world and prepare themselves carnally, physically. All right, but that's not going to save them. All right. And salvation is only for Israel. Okay. And first off, you gotta get right with the Lord first. Repent if you're so called Negro, Latino, Native American. You gotta repent and get right with the Lord. Alright. Order thy way aright. Okay. Seek the Lord. Okay. And it says, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. All right. So, and everybody know Matthew, the 24th chapter, you know, you know, even some Christians know that. So it says, I'm going to read that again. It says, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world, then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. Okay. I'm going to actually read all the way down because it's, you know, this the times we're living in. Yeah, I'm gonna stop at 15. All right, and it says, for like as all that is made in the world hath a beginning and the end is manifest. And we're watching the end manifest. All right, because everyone that's in their right mind can come to the same conclusion that it's the end of the world. Okay, and we're going to see who is that world. Because we know it's the end of the world. So who is the end of the world? It's Esau. We're going to get that precept. Alright. Let me get the other one first. Yeah. This Proverbs 14 and 15. The simple believe of every word, but the prudent man looketh well to his going. Okay? And it's another one. Yeah. Proverbs 22 and 3. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but the simple pass on and are punished. So sheep led to the slaughter. All right? There you go. It's 2nd Ezra 6 and 9. 2nd Ezra 6 and 9. For Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. So we're at the end of the world, okay? The end of an age, a rulership, okay? And the Lord is about to establish his kingdom on earth, all right? And he's about to take down the current superpowers of the earth today. That make up the NATO and the EU, all right? This whole beast, this dragon, okay? And the dragon is predominantly made of Edomites, so-called white people, you know? And the scriptures talk about these other kings giving their power to the beast, you know? You know, these other nations besides Edomites, so-called white people, you know, that's in bed with Esau, you know, they're going to get taken down too. But the point is, it shows you who's ruling the earth in these last days. And we know that the so-called white people run the world today, you know, so-called Jewish. All right. So process of elimination, they got to be the Edomites, you know, just off this one precept. You know, so it says 2nd Ezra 6 and 9, for Esau is the end of the world and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. All right. And then you got Edomites coming out the wheel works with information, you know, so. And that goes back to Psalm 64, because they telling on themselves, you know? They telling on themselves. So, hey, there's truth coming out. They can't Esau, these elites, you know, the leadership, the head of this snake, you know, they can't stop it, you know? They can't stop it. So these elites, they about to come down with great wrath, all right? They plans getting, is being foiled. And exposed, all right, by the prophets, but you know, by the voice of God, you know, which are the prophets, all right, beginning with the elder apostles of Great Millstone, all right. So, and not only that, you got whistleblowers backing up the prophets, you know, that goes back to the scripture in Revelation. It says, the earth shall help the woman, that woman represents the elect, you know. The elect, because the elect, we're professing that we're the true Hebrew Israelites that the Bible speaks of. All right? That we're the people of the Lord, the chosen people, peculiar people. And you got the earth helping us. meaning you got other races bearing witness, you know, claiming that the so-called Negroes are the true Jews, okay? You got history, all that, artifacts, you know? So you got paintings, you know, all that good stuff. You know, you got even got information in the Zondervan Bible Dictionary, okay? So Esau is like, there's truth, he can't hide it, he can't contain it. It's just, you know, and it's a precept, let me get it. Truth, spring. Okay. It's another one too. I just reworded it wrong. It's another one in, I believe, Second Ezra. It says, Psalms 85 and 11, truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. And that's exactly what's happening. All the lies and the stealing and killing and theft, okay, is being exposed. It's being brought out, you know? All right. So let's continue. It says, 2 Ezra 9 and 6, even so, the times also the highest have plain beginnings and wonder and powerful works and endings and effects and signs. You know, so you countlessly seeing blood moons and, you know, solar eclipses and all that, you know, and these super moons, you know, which these are different signs of the times. And not too long ago, you had the planets, you know, the alignment of the planets and all that stuff, you know. So when you see these things, that means something big is about to happen on the earth, okay? And you constantly seeing, it's a norm now to see chariots, so-called UFOs, you know. It's a worldwide thing now, you know. It's not a mystery to people. They don't, you know, which these simpletons, they don't know what a chariot is. But if you mention UFO, you know, pretty much majority of the people on the earth that's not living under a rock, you know, they can say they seen one in the sky or they seen it on YouTube. Either or, you know. So this truth is springing forth. Okay, so it says, and everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby ye have believed. Okay. Let's jump down. It says, this 15, I have said before and now do speak and will speak it also hereafter, that there be many more of them which perish than of them which shall be saved. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Now we're going to jump down to 22. Second Ezra 9 and 22. Let the multitude perish then which was born in vain, and let my grape be kept and my plant, for with great labor have I made it perfect. And that's just that grape be kept that represents the chosen, the elect, okay? And Lord willing, I'm a part of the number. Now let's get the other one. Other precept. So like I forgot the precept I was about to get. Oh, okay. I remember. It just came back to me. This Acts 4 and 12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Okay, so it's only one true name. All right. And guess what? The name is in Hebrew, and I've been saying it since I entered the start of the video. Okay? So, it's only one name you can be saved by. And it's not that Yiddish bullshit. All right? You know, because that so-called, I mean, not so-called, but those other names like, you know, Yahuwah and Yahweh and all that, that was created, you know, by a so-called white man. All right? You know, and then when you go deeper into that, you know, you had two Jakes that came up with it. So I might just do a sit down on that, going into that, you know. But this is information you can, like in Daniel's, they say knowledge shall be increased. People should run to and fro, knowledge should be increased. So you can easily look this up and see what those names trace back to, which they're lies. Okay? Those, you know, Yahuwah and Yahweh and all that, Yeshua, you know, those are false names. Those are not the real names of the Heavenly Father and the Son. Okay? And it was man-made, you know, which, Lord willing, I remember to do a sit-down on that. Okay? So with that, we can end it. Want to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah Ba'ashem, Yahweh Kakodash. Double honors to my elder apostles, a great millstone, rule and teach well. And honors and salutations to the elect across the four corners. The men that's pushing this truth throughout the four corners. All right. And Shalom.